Good morning, welcome to the Art Money Talk. My name is Mo. Today's question is, should I pay to exhibit my art? One day I received this private message on Instagram from a young artist saying, I was contacted by an art gallery in Italy. They offered to exhibit my artwork for a year for 800 euros. I have never exhibited in an art gallery before. Should I accept this deal? I went to check on this art gallery. Actually, it's a real gallery in Italy because, you know, sometimes there are scams and sometimes there are real galleries. You can never be too careful. So I went to check. If you're an adult, I will answer you this question with another question. Would you pay to have sex? Yes, I'm serious. Usually among my friends, there are two kind of attitudes. One attitude being, I will never pay to have sex. It means, you know, I'm not attractive for them to do it for free. It means it's not love, it's so wrong, it means it's illegal, you know, it's, you know, human trafficking involved. They have their reasons to not pay to have sex. I have also another kind of attitude among my friends is, why not? We're adults, we decide, you know, among ourselves what to do. We all have to eat, right? So sometimes people having difficult times is just lending a helping hand. I'm associating paying to have sex and paying to exhibit your art because it all comes down to one thing. Are you attractive enough for them to do it for free? Well, personally, I will never pay to exhibit my art because I believe it has to come from them. They have to like my art to do it for free with me. However, you are adult, you decide what you want to do. I have my reasons. Because I believe it is not right to ask for an initial 800 euro and charge a 50% commission fee. I think it's not correct for art galleries to do that. In Madrid, there is a little cute space called White Lab along Metro Line 1. I've been to the place several times, you know, it's well presented, it's quite professional. It's a lovely space. They have two kind of services. Number one, you pay 2,500 euros and they will exhibit your art for 14 days. During this time, if anything sold, you don't pay any commission. Number two, you pay no initial fee, but anything sold during that time, you will pay 50% commission. Even you bring your own friend and your friend decides to buy artwork, same, you pay 50% commission to the gallery because they have a professional team, right? They're not charity. They have to pay their staff, they have to pay utility bills and rent. It's not very cheap to sustain a place, you know, in the city center. So I think it is fair that they gave you the choice. You pay the fee, you don't pay commission. Or you pay no fee, you pay the commission. And it's your choice to either go for it or not work with them. Of course, it's your choice. I know some other galleries, they're charging $5,000, $10,000 to bring an art piece to Miami. And even they're charging their own artist under their representation. And I think it's not right. Something's wrong. And perhaps that's why so many artists decided to go for ArtFinder, Saatchi Art. They'd rather pay 40% commission to this kind of online marketplaces because artists are tired of playing this game. Every coin has two sides. This story has also another side. Think about it. Why galleries are doing this? Before, galleries are not asking money. Why they become such a devil? A gallerist friend of mine told me this story. She said, well, I can't sustain my business anymore. I have lost two of my best artists in 2 years and they went for a bigger gallery. They abandoned me after 10 years of nurturing them, mentoring them, working with them, promoting them, marketing them, building their brand. They left me, you know, with nothing and I cannot sustain my business. I have to sell my gallery. I'm done. Of course, this is not a nice behavior, it's not moral, it's, you know, it's not right. You cross the bridge and you burn it right away after crossing. This is totally not an ethical behavior in this industry. And perhaps that's why so many galleries are asking money in a way to cope with the bad behavior from so many artists. In China, we have a tradition called bride money or bride price. So before a man gets married with a woman, the man has to pay a large sum of money, usually 5 grand to 50 grand dollars to a woman's family just at the engagement. This is a large sum of money. Sometimes it's a family's life saving. This money serves two purposes. Number one, if the man treats the woman badly in the marriage, she could always run back to her parents' house and she has this money to start a new life. Number two, so the man pays a large sum of money to the woman's family, so unlikely he has spare money to spend on dating other women. You see, it's a way to commit in a relationship. In this case, I would say the gallerist is the woman. The gallerist is trying to say, hey, are you serious with me? Are you committing with me? And then the artist is trying to say, well, I like you, you're all cool and stuff, you know, but let me see if I can find better. When the gallerist commit, they commit with time and money and a large opportunity cost. And when they put in the work, they build a brand for the artist. So when the artist leaves, really they were left with nothing. In this case, a gallerist would like to see the artist commit as well with perhaps 800 euros. However, I think this is not the right way to do it, and perhaps we can do it like this. The 800 euros is a deposit. If the artist ends the contract before, let's say 1 year, 2 years, 3 years duration of the contract, he loses the deposit. If he complies and do everything right in the end of the contract period, he gets the money back. I'm not sure if this is the best way to build trust, but this is commonly done in many other industries. For example, if you rent an apartment, rent a business premises, usually you have to pay a deposit. And if you do everything right, make no damage, you get it back. If you do it wrong, you lose the deposit. So if I'm the artist in this story, I will write back to the art gallerist in Italy saying this. I'm a serious artist, I would like to work with you. Let's do this. Let's sign a 3-year contract. Every year, I will send you 30 pieces of artwork. You represent me exclusively in Italy or in Italy with other countries in Southern Europe. I can pay you $800 for the first year, but after, from the second year, you take it from my sales account. However, there's one condition. This 800 euros can only spend in one thing, is my communication. You see, usually art gallerists complain that when the artist breaks the contract and leaves the gallery and they lose the communication money. So if the artist pays for the communication, I think it's totally a win-win solution. The gallerist win the money and win the collaboration, and the artist win communication and the chance to sell. And we are making sure that this collaboration is built on good faith. What about you? What do you think? Do you have a different solution? Write me in the comment below. That's it for today. Thanks for watching and thanks for bearing with me with my broken voice. See you in the next video.